Hey there, Sunday school families and teachers. Hope you're doing well this day. Looking at the story, the text for our next in-person session on the 28th, I believe, which is Palm Sunday, we're going to be looking, we're finally out of the book of Genesis, and now we're moving into the book of Exodus. And a story that the kids, I think, will enjoy, one that probably they might even be familiar with. It's the story of Moses being born and being rescued and being brought into the household of the king of Egypt, we would say the Pharaoh. So as we jump into the book of Exodus, we realize that quite a bit of time has passed since Joseph and his family ended up in Egypt. He was in charge. The Pharaoh was favorably disposed towards Joseph and his family. But now it's over 300 years later, closer to 400. New leadership is in place. And as we know in our own country, when new people come into power, it can be good or it can be very, very bad. By this point, for the Israelites, this new Pharaoh is not good news for them. Good news for the people of Israel, and a good lesson for you and me today, is here we have God's people, a forerunner of us, the church of God today, finding themselves in a foreign land in very bad situation. But we see the fact that God is still blessing them. They have become known now as a people, as a nation, not just as a family or a tribe. They are the Israelites, the Hebrew people. And God has blessed them. They have been grown in numbers greatly, which is why the Pharaoh, in part, fears them. He has this huge population of foreign-born people that worship a different God, doesn't worship him as God. And so he's going to do what he can to oppress them. Now, keep in mind, as we begin to go into this book of Exodus, what we see happening there is really a battle between God, the true God, and the gods of Egypt. Remember that Pharaoh himself was considered himself a god, in many ways the greatest god, which is why when we go into the plagues and the last plague of the Passover, the firstborn of every household being killed, that God was really going after the newborn son of Pharaoh, which would be the next heir apparent, the next God. So this is really a showdown where God proves not only himself, his might and power that he is the only God, but also how he is always working for the good of his people. So again, a new Pharaoh fears the people. So the first thing he does is he oppresses them. He makes them work very, very hard. That doesn't stop them from growing in numbers. So he goes right at the children, a sad reminder of the struggle we have in our life today with the tragedy that is abortion. Here, the Pharaoh orders the death of the males. Of course, males would have been considered more of a threat to Pharaoh, so that's why he went after them. But throughout this, we see also people who feared God. The servants, the people of Israel, the midwives who helped to deliver these children. We see a couple times where in the text it says they feared God. A reminder, we hear the word fear and we think afraid of some entity that's seeking to hurt us in some way that has caused us harm or danger. But there's another sense of understanding the word fear, and that is a respect, a humbleness before, to be in awe of something is to fear it. And that's really what this term means used here, is that these midwives, that these people truly did love and trust in God above all things, we would say, looking at the Ten Commandments. So God continues to work and God continues to preserve. Pharaoh first tries to oppress them by making them work terribly hard. That doesn't work. He orders the killing of the male children. God works through people to preserve them and preserves this one called Moses, born to very obviously believing parents. They do what they can to protect their son. They put him in a basket. And again, God's divine wisdom and direction. He works very specifically here to preserve Moses, who ends up being found by Pharaoh's daughter, who essentially adopts him. And Moses ends up in the best of both worlds, a true Hebrew child, a child of the chosen people of God, but raised in the courts of Pharaoh himself. In the midst of this, too, it's not mentioned, but to understand that as Aaron is a little bit older than Moses, Aaron would be the first priest, would be one who would work with Moses, that he obviously was preserved here, too. So just a neat story that often kids really can get into. It's a fun story, an easy story to tell. It's got some dark tones to it, some dark parts of it, but it also points directly to our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. And just as Moses was drawn out of the water to be saved, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ came out of the waters of his baptism to save us, to lead us out of slavery in Egypt, or in sin, just as Moses led the Israelites of his day out of slavery in Egypt. And in the same way, he draws you and I out of the waters of slavery in our own baptism. And today, as we look at our world, and a good reminder for our children that there are good days and there are bad days, and we're not going to deny that. We're going to own up to them that we're going to have bad days. I remember there was some children's book when my children were young, it might still be popular, about the terrible, no good, very bad day, that even in those days, God is with us. He forgives us. He loves us. He strengthens us, and he works good for all who love him in their baptism. So a few thoughts for you as you look at this. You could talk about how God works in our lives, even in bad situations, how God is always with us. And most importantly, talk about Jesus and all that he has done for us. So hope this is helpful. Hope you have a great time talking about this and discussing this with your children or teaching this in class. And hope you have a great day.